Owning the railway wasn't enough. Now Starrick has bought an omnibus company as well. I suppose he wants to control the neighborhood's workers and keep them under his thumb.
Pearl Attaway is Starrick's competitor, is she? Perhaps it's time I went into business.
And Miss Fry, what are your plans?
I studied the history we recovered from the Kenway Mansion's hidden room. I'm off to a certain monument. Seems a letter has come for Jacob.
Thank you. Disraeli, members of Parliament and
so the hints you found in the Kenway House lead to the monument.
What a wonderful use of your time, following me around asking obvious questions.
Well, since Henry isn't here, I thought you might enjoy the company.
I don't require any company, and Mr. Green is following up on some leads of his own.
Oh, yes, Mr. Green. That's a fascinating idea. Oh, please, Mr. Green, come and take a look at this book and stand oh so close to me, Mr. Green.
I do not. Too many today live in what. Well, perhaps you have nothing better to do, but I'm busy protecting the assassins.
Are you really? What was it Father used to say?
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission.
Precisely. Anyway, I'm off. If I find any more wild geese for you to chase, I'll be in touch.
Be ever more pleasant for your absence.
Need not be a fire hazard. We have heard your concerns. There is no need for shouting. Please calm down. There's no need for all this disruption. Too many today live in what are little better than hovels, in crowded conditions near open flame, and with few methods of fire control. Will you please stop shouting? You are only being moved out of your homes if it is unsafe.
Thank you.
In an effort to ensure so great a tragedy will never happen again,
I would
like to thank our esteemed guests, the Right Honourable Premier Disraeli, members of Parliament and others for being here today. Our proposed legislation will ensure that housing for the impoverished need not be a fire hazard.
We have heard your concerns. There is no need for shouting. Please calm down.
Safer housing, sanitation facilities, and less open play.
What a racket! You sound like a bunch of children! You are being very unfaithful! Do you really want to keep living in fire? Well, we cannot continue this until you harm ourselves.
We are gathered here at the moment.
This looks familiar. There you go. Slowly. Slow down.
Huh?
It's in the very top. The key to the vault, and the shroud.
Good day, Miss Fry. I'll take that.
You want the shroud to cement your own power. But what if you cannot control it?
Why do you want the shroud? Merely to keep the Templars from having it? How like an assassin. To hold the power of eternal life, and yet be too afraid to use it.
Eternal life? Is that what you think the shroud offers?
What I think is no longer your concern.
Miss Fry, what a pleasant surprise.
Hello, Clara. I was just going to check on Lambeth since the asylum's closing. What brings you here?
The children in my care have been falling ill. Our usual tonics aren't working. A cane, too.
Are you certain you're feeling all right?
Of course. I am, miss.
Clara! Is there a doctor nearby?
Bring her inside. She simply collapsed?
Yes, she said the others took tonic, but it didn't work.
I should think not. Ever since Elliotson was murdered, the district has been overrun with counterfeit tonics. This one needs proper care. But without the appropriate medication, she and the others will quickly decline.
What do you need?
I need supplies. Plenty of them. And medicine. Some of the less common ingredients are being stolen and sold at auction.
I'd be happy to help.
Here's the list. Miss
Fry. Evie Fry.
I'm Miss Nightingale. How do you do? Please hurry. We don't have much time.
Let's not draw any attention to ourselves. I require your help.
Right, I'll follow.
On your way, then.
All right.
But you can ask any of my customers. This is guaranteed to cure your son's ailment.
What's this then? Thieves these days are gonna win well.
It's just that it's so expensive.
Here now.
Help! thank you enough. These supplies are meant for Miss Nightingale.
I'm here to collect them.
And they're already loaded on the cart. Please take them.
Giddy up!
You mean that cart?
Yes.
Of course it is.
Please be careful. Some of those items are fragile.
That's it.
Not a moment too soon. I hope you brought the medication I requested.
How is she?
She will recover.
Babylon Alley, the children.
Thanks to you, we can distribute authentic medicine now.
But is that a permanent solution?
I will petition to have regulations put in place.
Lambeth is in your debt.
It takes a long time to change things. But I'm not going anywhere, Miss Fry.
Miss Attaway,
Yes, may I? Oh. Splendid, you're here to murder me.
I what?
No matter, everyone has a prize. Is this enough?
I'm not here to kill you.
And what's your game?
Mr. Starrick and the Milner Company have blocked your ambitions long enough. I have a business proposition for you.
Wonderful. Come with me. We have much to discuss, Mr.
Jacob Fry. At your service.
Truer words were never spoken.
If you'd be so kind as to take the reins. You must understand, I've received threats against my life. Malcolm Milner has all but waged war on me since Mr. Starrick brought out his company. And no offense, I hope, but you do look the king.
I doubt I shall ever recover from such a slight.
What then is your interest in my redemption, Mr. Fry?
I sense an opportunity that will benefit us both.
Do you?
Is that so hard to believe?
Whatever your intentions, it will be quite the tonic to strike back against Milner and Starrick. That's one of Milner's.
Walk on, girl.
Malcolm Milner, Starrick's puppet himself.
Careful, you twats! This park scene needs to make it to the Outway Depot.
He thinks he can burn my buses. Let's give him a taste of his own medicine.
Let's give him the whole damn bottle. We'll turn Milner's park scene against him. But I'll need help from my gang.
Such entrepreneurial instinct, Mr. Fry. I shall leave you to it.
Thank you.
Heave ho, Jacob. Primed and ready.
Plummeting already. You're hired. Oh, I have more business planned for us both. Drop a note to my secretary to make an appointment, and I shall reveal the next step in our scheme.
I don't actually work.
Like that.